Dear students, welcome to video lecture series on food and cosmetic analysis. In this seventh video, you are going to learn about analysis of lactose or sugar of a milk by Lane-Yon method. So in this video, we are going to see the analysis of lactose sugar present in the milk by using the Lane-Yon method. So here is the analysis of lactose or sugar of a milk. So here we are going to discuss the detailed procedure for analysis of a lactose or sugar present in the milk. So it is done by Lane-Yon method. It is based on determination of volume of a test solution required to reduce completely a known volume of alkaline copper reagent. The end point is indicated by use of an internal indicator methylene blue. This dye is reduced to methylene white by a slight excess of reducing sugar over that necessary to reduce all the copper. So here is the detailed procedure. However, the methylene white is rapidly oxidized back to methylene blue due to presence of air. Hence, it is necessary to exclude air. So, exclusion of air is accomplished by performing the titration while a solution being analyzed in boiling condition. Diluted sample of milk is treated with copper sulfate, pentahydrate, and sodium hydroxide. So, now we are going to discuss the exact detailed procedure about estimation or analysis of a lactose or sugar present in the milk. We have to take a diluted milk sample and we have to treat it with a copper sulfate pentahydrate solution and sodium hydroxide. So the NaOH added should be sufficient to precipitate completely as a copper as a hydroxide. The solution is filtered and the filtrate is transferred in a burette. Mixed filling reagent is taken in conical flask and is placed on a wire gauze and it is heated to boiling. It is rapidly titrated against the sugar solution filled in a burette till dye gets reduced. So, diluted milk sample is treated with copper sulfate pentahydrate solution and sodium hydroxide to precipitate completely as a copper as a hydroxide. Okay, so whatever the procedure is explained, here we are going to see by using a picture. So here is a diluted milk sample. In this diluted milk sample, we have to add NaOH solution and copper sulfate solution. So when we add NaOH, all the copper will precipitate as a copper hydroxide. Then next, the solution is filtered and the filtrate is transferred into a burette. So here is shown. This copper hydroxide precipitate solution is filtered and the filtrate and precipitate is separated. This filtrate is then transferred into the burette and taken for titration. A filtrate is transferred into burette, rapidly titrated against mixed filling reagent till dye gets reduced. Okay, so this filtrate which is obtained by the previous step is transferred into the burette and it is titrated rapidly with a boiled mixed filling reagent. Okay, so here we have to use the mixed filling reagent and it should be in a boiled form. Okay, so we have already discussed why boiled form is required, because the atmosphere contains oxygen. This oxygen can reduce back the dye. So that's why it should be used in boiled condition so that the air oxygen should be removed from the solution. Here the how to prepare mixed filling reagent. Filling A solution should be prepared by taking 7 gram copper sulfate pentahydroxide pentahydrate dissolved in distilled water containing 2 drops of dilute sulfuric acid, and this solution should be 50 ml. Then filling B, 35 gram of potassium tartrate and 12 gram of NaOH in 100 ml of distilled water. This should be of 15 ml. These two solution, if you mix filling A and filling B, that form a mixed filling reagent, and we have to take this solution under boiled condition. Okay, so hot solution we have to take and we have to titrate it. So in this way we can determine the amount of sugar present in the solution. From the burette reading, the amount of filtrate which is get reduced, we can calculate the amount of sugar present in the solution. So this way, in this video, you have learned about analysis of lactose or sugar of a milk by Le-Inon method. Please learn next topic of this unit in my next video. Till then, I thank you for watching this video and I wish you a very happy e-learning.